Hey guys, this is Colin. Just wanted to take a minute to thank you, the listener, for listening and proving that you have a growth mindset. Our mission is to curate information from the top influencers around the world. We provide you with real, actionable steps on how to improve in any and every area of your life. Whether you own your own business, you're a C-suite executive, or just starting your journey of self-development, the Brofessional Development Podcast is all about growth. And you know, if you're not growing, you're dying. If you enjoy this content, please help us help others by liking, sharing, and subscribing.
Hey guys, welcome to the Brofessional Development Podcast. Today is Wednesday, August 18th, and we've got a pretty special episode for a couple of reasons. Number one, it is episode 50, so we're halfway to 100. Number two, we are kicking it old school with our buddy Colin McNeil in studio.
Woo!
You know, you know, I heard the button go off in the background.
That was the worst. I wanted to fucking kill somebody.
And then have a dog piss on your shoe.
Dan woke up nightmares hearing that sound in his head. He hated it so much, which made us
that
love it even more.
Love it. A little bit more.
Then you'd play the sad trombone and he'd be even more sad.
So Colin, talk to us. What's been going on in your world?
Nothing much, man. Same old.
Has life gone downhill since you quit the pod?
Yeah, it really has. I'm jobless, homeless. No.
Your pets' heads are falling off?
No, everything's actually been very good. Transitioning over into my, I'm leaving my company now and transitioning over into my own company. So McNeil Insurance Group will be a thing. It's been a slow transition, but it's been really good. I'm really, really excited about it.
So is that through, like, you just completely branched off, or did you hit your metrics and numbers to the point where you were able to?
I just transitioned. Yeah, so
nice.
I was able to transition and take my books. Yeah.
Congrats.
Yeah,
that's
awesome.
If I recall correctly, like, that was on the goal planning that we did in Colorado.
It was.
I think it's all those homeowners and policies I gave him.
Yeah.
All of them. So essentially, you're welcome.
Yeah.
I mean,
no, yeah.
Like,
for real.
You're welcome.
I do contribute a lot of my success to this group. The original book club. Nobody believed I was in a book club. I'd be like,
yeah, we believed I was in a book club.
Yeah, dude, for real. I would ask my future mother-in-law, I'd be like, hey, can you watch the baby today? Book club tonight.
She's like, okay.
She's like, yeah, fucking right. But no, Dan asked me 10 minutes ago if I could come onto this podcast today. And obviously I wanted to make it work because I'm very proud of everybody at this table.
Yeah.
I think I saw a lot of people elevate their game and take it to the next level from the time we started to now, you know.
Oh, for
especially
sure.
Dan.
Yeah.
No, so I'm happy to be here. So
good. We're happy to have you, man.
Yeah, man.
So
excited.
Today, do we have any other topics we want to shoot the shit on?
I got something.
Yeah.
Because me and Dan disagreed about this yesterday.
Here we go.
Yeah.
And it's about natural talent. Do you guys think natural talent exists?
I don't. So I'm in the camp that natural talent does not exist. However, genetically, you can't do things. You know, you're not going to make the NBA at 5'4". Well, I think one person has done it. So if one person can do it, more people can do it. But yeah, I mean, like, genetically, there's some things that I don't think you can learn.
And I think that there is natural talent and ability that people are born with, whether that's in sports or in business or just in life in general. But I think the issue is that a lot of people never tap into their natural ability and they don't take advantage of it. And it just goes to be useless.
I completely agree.
Yeah. See, yeah. Dan sucks.
So I actually
read a book on this by a fucking scientist.
Oh,
or
yeah.
Somebody, a doctor of
I'm
some
sure
sort.
There's another
Can
book
you source that?
It's
that
called
ours?
The Talent Code.
I'm sure there's another book that argues the same thing.
But there's, we've talked about this a while ago. There's actually studies that show mindsets can translate over through generations and generations of beliefs about being broke and not being able to make money and being a victim of circumstance. So I believe if that can happen, then the talent can translate over. But again, it all comes down to if the person's going to what they're doing with that talent in the right situations or putting in the work.
Exactly.
No, so in terms of talent, in the Talent Code, Daniel Coyle is who wrote this, but explain to me why, you know, three of the best, you know, 20 women's tennis players of all time come from one small town that was poverty stricken, right? Like, did they all just born with world you know,
maybe it was level, the water.
You know, yeah. So drinking water creates talent. No, but
as long
so,
as it's spring water.
So basically, like putting in the work. I mean, you've seen. You even posted the Conor McGregor post. Like, this is all hard work.
Yeah.
Right.
You posted like, that.
Or who posted that?
Was
Bob. It,
right. Yeah.
Okay. And what did
it
say?
It was from
what
the
did
podcast.
Say?
That shit. Yeah.
It basically saying that hard work beats talent all
there's
day.
There's no talent. Okay. Yeah, there's no talent.
So
here. It's all obsession.
You have to work hard. You have to have. You have to love what you're fucking doing. Okay, so you have to love what you do. You have to have a good coach, and you like. And if you put all that together, that's where the talent starts to develop itself. Like, I don't think anybody's born a fucking rock star.
I look at a guy though, like Ken Griffey Jr. Like that motherfucker didn't train one day in his entire career.
Ooh, I don't know if I don't know about.
But what
that.
Did he do when he was a kid?
I don't know.
Right, like because the kid that's taking 1,000 swings a day because he's fucking obsessed with it, and you have nothing to do. But take swings, like
yeah,
you
but
can
I
develop
also feel
a skill
like there's those
set
kids
that's
that
carry
we grew up with who were like, you played soccer, you played basketball. The kid was just fucking good.
Could
and
just
then
dribble ball.
When they realized that they were really good at this, then yeah, they pour fuel on the fire.
So
that's what I'm coming from.
What I will say is that's called deliberate practice. Like I think, you know, looking at golf, right? Like there's some people that practice all the time, but they don't know how to practice, so they never get better because they're not practicing correctly. And so I think that the kids who get really good at something, either, yeah, they have a higher cognitive ability or they learn things faster, ability to learn maybe, but I don't think there's a natural talent. I think that they're either learning faster or they're practicing more deliberately on the things that they need to practice on. Like Jordan Belfort said, he learned another language. And
but we'll have him on the podcast.
Like, yeah, we will. Yeah, Jordan, anytime.
Don't read his fucking book, though.
So anyways, I guess that's where I'm coming from with my argument.
So,
is that,
yeah. Both good points. Embrace debate. Only way to solve it is either deathmatch or we put a poll on Instagram at the end of this.
I vote a deathmatch.
Yeah, that's what I'm going with.
Tie our dicks together.
Well, I guess I could agree because I would beat Brad at a go-kart race.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I mean, natural
and I would eat Dan at a hot dog eating contest.
Oh,
okay. I can see a lot of hot dogs in your mouth.
You bet. Yeah.
Hey-o. All right, any other shoot the shit topics before we get into the main
course?
How
come nobody else contributed there, Dan?
I don't know.
What?
I guess we're passionate about it.
Yeah.
Come on, guys. Pick it up today.
Well, listen,
the 50th
we got a,
episode.
But here's the thing. I wanted to dump everything into the main shit. Because this is a big episode, right?
Half century.
We're halfway there.
Over the hill.
Halfway to 100. I was looking up like different terms for it. It could be like called our golden episode.
Golden years already.
Yeah. Which is weird. Bicentennial. Yep. That was another one. Semi-centennial, which kind of sounds weird. But yeah. So today, what we're going to do, we're essentially going to talk about how we started as a podcast, kind of our favorite moments, how we've grown as a podcast, personally, professionally, and ultimately where we feel like the podcast is going to go in the future. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off with quotes. And these are just going to be your favorite quotes of either all time or since you started the podcast. So who wants to kick it off?
I have to say mine first because somebody will steal it. Okay. That's why I used mine today.
Go for it.
So mine was Henry Ford. It's whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. Because I think we tried to use that like 4 times on the podcast.
It's a very popular one. So. Yep. But very, very true because we talk about it in some capacity in every episode.
Yeah. I have one from, I've said it's on here before, but from FM Alexander, people do not decide their future. They decide their habits and their habits decide their future. This past year has been a year of just a lot of transition for, I think, a lot of different people. And one thing that I've just realized is that if you don't have good habits, you're fucked. So you have to make changes.
Mm-hmm. Mine is, if you can dream it, you can do it. Walt Disney. Obviously, I'm a dreamer. And so I think anybody can do anything that they want to. And you shouldn't put limitations around your mindset. So what do you do? You got anything?
Yeah. I like my favorite quote is by Conor McGregor is I want to find that place where most people quit and I want to be there as much as possible. I think that speaks to me so much. I'm a big believer in separation days on the days when you don't feel like it and your mind's telling you no to just go to the gym or get your ass to the office or just keep doing what you're doing. Don't give up.
I think one of the best feelings is either working at something when you know nobody else is working, exactly. Yeah. Whenever your competition isn't working mm-hmm. at the same time. Because you fucking know.
That's a fucking, yeah. That is a good ass feeling. And I didn't like, I've felt it before earlier in my career and a couple other times, like sporadic, like periodically, I guess you could say. And then like during 75 hard for sure. And then even after 75 hard, because I didn't have to concentrate on the workouts and stuff as much, like over and over again, like times in the office at like till like 9 o'clock at night, or like I would get home from volleyball every once in a while at like 11 o'clock, 11:30, and I'd pop on my computer and start doing shit. Like it's a good feeling, and it's cool to kind of get addicted to that feeling.
For yeah, sure. And I think that to parlay on that, like separation is in the preparation, right? Yeah. At Milet, I don't know if anybody else said that, but I think it's at Milet. And you know, whenever you show up to an event, whether it's a sporting thing or some type of competition or in business or to a meeting, whatever, like you can sit there and mentally prepare by saying, I know that I worked harder than every other motherfucker in the room. And so I know that I can be successful because I practiced on the days that they didn't, or I worked on the days that they didn't. So I'm more prepared than they are. And that's just a confidence boost, I think.
For sure. Yep. mine, actually, I don't know who this was from, but we referenced it on the podcast before, and I think it kind of embodies this episode. It's, you're the product of the people you surround yourself and the content you consume. I tried to Google it, who it was, but I know we've talked about that.
I think that was Dan Greiner.
Yeah.
No.
I love that quote, though. I love that quote.
Yeah,
it's
good.
That's something that I've been doing very deliberately is filtering out people of, you know, out of my circle.
And it's why we did the podcast, right? It's like we wanted to surround ourselves Absolutely. With people that wanted to grow, that wanted to be successful in every facet of life. And we wanted to produce content that was going to help that.
So. And I think that's a good starting point. I mean, for today's episode is really like, why did we start this? And it's because we get to talk about shit that if you talked about it barbecue, everybody look at you like you're fucking crazy,
yeah,
you know?
Sure.
And now we have a forum where we all get together and talk about how we can get better. And really a lot of people don't have that circle in their life to do that on a weekly basis. So.
Have you guys had the revelation, like, when you're talking to somebody and you're talking about your dreams or you're talking about the things we would talk about here, and you're talking to somebody and they're just like, you're out there, you know?
They just the
they don't get it. They just
don't
get it.
I don't talk to those people anymore.
And I've always
talked about it.
I've lived my life on the assumption that people think the same. Everybody wants to get to the same place, but they don't, you know?
I think everybody's
seen it different.
No, I was just going to say, I literally had a guy come into my office today and he was just like, hey, what do you have going on this afternoon? And I was like, well, I'm doing this, this, and this. Then I'm heading to the podcast. And he's like, oh, that's cool, man. And I was like, what do you got going on? And he's like, well, I'm dipping out. I got to go do this. And he just is an excuse not to work, basically, that day. And, he was like, he's like, man, I just wish I could do what it is that you do. And I'm like, I'm doing nothing special.
Yeah.
Like, I'm doing nothing special. I'm just showing up. And he was like, well, he's like, to be honest, I just don't want to work that hard. And I was like, all right.
At least he's honest.
Glad you're on my leadership team.
At least he's honest. Actually, that's where those separation days really show up for me is when like somebody tells you what, you know, like what they're up to or why they don't want to go to the gym or whatever. And you're like, man, I've made that excuse too. I know it's an excuse, you know, so.
Everybody's got them. And like, hate to say it, but you do kind of need those people to be employees sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
For
yeah,
sure.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, that was one of my fears. Like, well, to your point, like, why doesn't everybody have the same mindset? And it is weird to me that, like, people don't have the same growth mindset. Like, why wouldn't you want to be the best version of yourself? I don't know what the quote is, but why wouldn't you give 100% when it's 100% your choice? Or by Tim Grover, I would think. Is that?
Sounds right.
Sounds right, yeah.
I think it is.
Yeah.
The thing that I find interesting is almost more, why don't people support others who succeed at their goals versus why the fuck are you doing that?
You know, maybe they just don't see life the same way that we see life or whatnot.
I mean, just like anything, any other thing, it's like people hate on things that they don't understand, right? It's whenever I started getting into self-development, I started posting shit on Facebook of like from books that I knew and anything that I was reading or podcasts that I was listening to. And then I had friends that would like comment on it, like super over the top corny stuff and like make fun of me. And it was in jest, obviously, but it was also like, they just don't get it. Like, mm-mm. And I stopped, like I let it stop me from posting that shit and kind of feeling like an idiot because at that time I really hadn't seen any success. But like, again, this is kind of all circles back to why we did the podcast, right? And it's just a thing that kind of just reaffirms that we're all trying to grow and we're all trying to get better. And I'd rather learn from people writing books about it and people growing multi-million dollar companies than taking the opinions of people that are working a corporate 9-to-5.
Yeah.
So
sure.
I love what you just said about like it stopped you from posting. Not like because it took me a while to get to this point, but now when I see people like make those jabs or say those things, it makes me understand that I'm on the right path. You know, like there's certain people out there who I know when they say that stuff, it's like, okay, I know I'm doing what's right. I know this is the right thing to do.
They're trying to bring people back down to their level, right?
And that's how they're feeling inside. Yeah.
It's the Snoop Dogg reel that was posted earlier this week, right? He's like, all these people that are trying to bring you back down, like, no, like, level up, bring people with you. And if they don't want to come, then fuck them.
Fuck them.
They're not part of your circle anymore.
Yep. Yeah. Well, I think there's also one other side to that is, you know, I see people post that shit and I'm not going to be like, oh yeah, okay. You know, because obviously I'm, you know, I try to live that. And when they post these quotes or whatnot, but then I don't see any action. Like they fucking post shit and then they don't do anything. It's, you know, I want to call them out because it's like, why are you just posting a bunch of motivational shit, but then you just stay in the same spot, you know?
But what does that do for you though?
It doesn't do, I mean.
But when you're having a conversation though, that would be the time, like what I've been trying to do.
Well,
is
I don't say anything.
Yeah, when I see somebody though and we're talking, I might say something like, but what are you really doing? Like, what are you doing? I don't know.
Well, then you're a dick. But that's okay. I mean, they think you're a dick.
I kind of like when people are like, yo, I see you not really doing shit. Okay, well.
Yeah.
Call you out on it, make you do something.
Yeah. I appreciate it almost. Respect it.
So I guess going off of that, we've had 50 episodes. And what would you say? So we'll go two ways with this. First, we're going to talk about your favorite episode that we had with just us on, and then we'll talk about our favorite guest. So, what was your favorite episode with just the professional crew?
My favorite episode, which I don't think maybe Colin was there for this one, was the minimum wage one. I thought that one was fun because I got to flirt with the edges of like being politically correct a little bit, and I think it kind of helped. Obviously, that's our highest downloaded podcast as well, but it was kind of cool to talk about stuff that I feel like passionate about, which is a little bit of politics.
Yeah. But no, the minimum wage, I had that listed as one of mine as well. Minimum wage equals minimum skill set. I mean, triple fire emoji. Like we were all
that
kind
was
of
podcast,
on top of it. We did our research on it. We gave facts and like numbers, you know, based off like actual research. And then I think the opinions were strong without, you know, having to worry about cancel culture.
Yeah.
Basically, people would just settle. Is that what it comes down to? Those type, the same types of people who would take a minimum wage job would just settle for that.
It was more about like you can't like demanding more wage for something that you're doing the minimum at a job.
Yeah,
and it's like why not just improve your skill set and get more money? That's the gist.
I got you.
Yeah.
I think my favorite episode was the law of attraction one, and it's just because I like to tell my story with figuring out the law of attraction.
Yep.
Because it sounds so fucking crazy to most people, and it sounded crazy to me. But then after you kind of dive in and you start to see like all these different things and then it all fits together in waves and all this stuff and
sure.
You realize that all this shit is real.
You are just a magnet.
Yeah. Are you guys like having the same vision right now where it's like we go back to like the studio and like you see like having that episode? Like a flashback every time we talk about it.
So I had Law of Attraction written down as mine as well because I think that was the first one.
It was your first episode.
That I was on and it was our second episode.
Yep. The second recorded episode.
Second recorded
officially,
episode.
Besides maybe a couple in that shitty studio
and
next door.
And I can see it. Like I remember being in, or actually we shouldn't even say the name of their place, should we, Rich?
No, you but, should so people don't go there.
Yeah, don't go to studio. Hey, come see Rich.
We've never bleeped anything. Rich, will you bleep that out? What was it called again?
Studio.
Okay, bleep that too.
Yeah.
I think it's important to note though, that place got us to this place.
It did.
That's right.
It
did. That was Callan's recommendation.
It was a stepping stone.
But like Matt said, when we went there, we felt like fucking ballers.
Damn, oh, dude, right. But
we're like, we had the video recording on us.
Yeah. It takes you to another
level. He did
do the
video. He did do the video.
Yeah.
And that then you put ads on our shit without our permission.
But you clearly graduated. You know
go
what I mean?
Circle
you understood
K.
Like this, dude, there's got to be something better.
Yeah.
You know?
So I didn't know that until, because I went back and listened to the first one and all of a sudden it was like, come on down to Mattress, yada, yada, yada.
Oh, no. The funniest shit about our first episodes was the thing that Brad put in place. And somebody thought it was you. What was it? It was like,
welcome to the Brofessional Development.
Yeah. And people were like, is that Matt?
The guy sounded like he was announcing one of the satellites for a strip club. And we got Diamond on satellite 2.
It's exactly how it was. God. We've grown so much.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
But I think that goes in the post we made this week where it's like, you just got to fucking start. It's going to be rocky. Like, you know what I mean? We're going to be in a studio with a dude with a lizard on his shoulder ripping a bong with no shirt on.
While his baby's in the back.
His two daughters are locked in a cellar. I've been in that basement.
Screen printing fucking operation with people that live down there.
That bathroom never had paper towels.
Yeah, he's always trying to hustle hoodies.
Oh, you washed your hands?
Oh, shit.
I tried. You posted something like $20. It was like, your first video's gonna suck. Your first podcast is gonna suck, right? What was it?
That was
just get started.
Yeah.
Your first, just anything that's your first is going to be bad, and you can't get to 100 times without starting. And so many people are just refusing to start because they're scared of failing. Yep. And most people don't fail because they don't even fucking start.
Yeah.
Remember the first time you guys fucked? That was a disaster.
I do remember it the first
was.
Time that I fucked.
For sure was.
Yeah, I did.
I don't know if I've grown a whole lot
from that. It was on the floor.
My hips didn't move the same.
That was mine was bad.
You know what? It was great for me.
Yeah, exactly.
It was great.
Maybe
you know?
Not for the other person.
Who knows? You know, maybe we'll have her on after one day.
Can we all bring our first song?
Can we?
Yes.
We need a list of every chick Matt has been with, and then
okay, then we'll
bring
make a list for you too. Everybody. We'll start throwing out Facebook messages, see what we can get on.
This will be great. This will be a great episode.
Me too.
We can give them each like 2 minutes to just rip the person apart.
Yes, that'd be amazing. That'd be an awesome segment. Bring on an ex.
It's not a bad idea.
All right.
That should be a loss too.
Did you have a favorite? Matt, did you have a favorite episode?
Mine was the same as Brad's.
Same as Brad's?
Yeah, for the most part. I had two, but yeah, for the most part it was that one. That one was pretty legit. Did you have one that you remember whenever you did with us?
I was actually going to say my favorite episode would have to be one of the ones at Overtime, just because I'm looking at you guys now and just I see especially you running the show. It's so organized and so like from the time we left Colorado, I feel like everything elevated. It's pretty special to see.
Remember when we thought about getting higher than Bat Tits in Colorado and doing a podcast? We should have done that.
We did. We literally got high.
Did we not record?
We did. We recorded for 4 or 5 hours, and it was me beating you guys at poker.
I would love to hear that recording.
And I probably just laughed the whole time.
Yeah.
That's where Brad's you should get it. You should go through that and chop that up. That's what you should do.
Yeah.
There's probably stuff we don't need out there on that.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Most likely.
So, did you say your favorite episode?
Yeah, mine was a minimum skill.
So, I have a quick question. What was your least favorite Just the Tip?
Oh, just a
it
tip.
It was for, and I know what you're gonna say. Can I say it?
Yeah.
It was Collins when he went on, and it was just like
about Kobe.
It was a story about Kobe Bryant. And then it was somebody.
It was Tim Grover, and then he was like, Kobe Bryant for 20 minutes.
Multiple subsectors of stories within that, and it ended up being like half the podcast.
He's like, so what'd you guys think?
And then we had to give some constructive criticism to the group and just say, hey guys, just the tip is supposed to be like 2 to 3 minutes long.
We haven't done just the tip in a while.
Brad, I thought you were really sincere when you were like, that was good.
That was real good. That was good.
I probably went home and told Paige, like, I killed it today.
Yeah.
The guys loved my tip.
Oh, my God. Dan, did everybody give theirs?
Yeah.
Okay. So who was your favorite, guest? And so I'll make mine really quick and go first. Most value I got was definitely from the Jeff Lopes podcast. Jeff is a G. He gave us like literally every possible tip that he could in terms of like building a following, and like how to reach out to guests, like grabbing their number, all this other stuff. And then the wow factor was obviously Andy Frisella, for as much as we talk about him. So I'll keep mine short.
Yeah, Andy Frisella. I don't even have to go into it.
I wrote down the same exact thing. The first form headquarters were just absolutely, I mean, it was incredible.
Yeah, I mean that, and then I really appreciated Ben Newman because he actually has helped me with shit. You know, just the way I think about
Andy process. Was here in studio. It was cool.
Yeah. I liked your episode with Ben Newman. I liked the one with Jason Selk, though.
Surprisingly, that one's outdone Ben Newman.
Yeah.
I'm kind of surprised.
I really like him. I think I
really like him. I'm with you. That might be the fact that I require every single person who joins my team to listen to that episode.
It was before you told me that, though.
It was even before that?
Like, he went through the roof right away. And I think it's because Jason Selk was Ben Newman's coach. I mean, like, he's just like, it's like recycled information. It's like the not quite as good as stuff.
Right.
And like, when we were with Selk, like, it was like, he was pretty tight-lipped, like, hey, like, you know, I don't kiss and tell, you know, and I thought that was cool.
I was asking about Cardinals players, and he was just like, he only told us about the ones who were the best, never about the ones who struggled or anything like that. It was like Chris Carpenter and Albert Pujols. Those are the best at it. Not going to say anything else.
Yeah, never
Chris
went
Carpenter's
deeper.
My favorite Cardinal of all time.
He's so great. Out of all the guests, I mean, everybody's been pretty cool. Is there any that least favorite kind of thing?
Least favorite?
And I don't mean to call anybody out, but I will say—
I know, like, Dan's.
Well, for me, like—
Is it also Andy Frisella?
No. Jordan Harbinger one, you know. Like, he opened up and he was cool kind of towards the end. But then there was some stuff going on with, like, what he pulled with somebody we know, which was interesting. And then when he first came on, he was kind of— he was just like—
I thought he was kind of a douche, too.
Yeah.
Like, he was just like, I'm here.
Yeah.
Like, pretty much every other guest we've had on, I've, like, actually felt like enjoyed coming on our
I really
our show.
Enjoyed it. And I like the Jason Selk one more than I like the Mickler one that I was a part of.
Yeah.
I really like Mickler a lot, but I thought that Jason Selk one was.
Selk was awesome.
Fun.
You had your doubts on Selk, like, right
when
we walked in.
Like, I would Rich too. Rich. Like, me and Rich walked into his house and we're like, fuck, this is going to be bad. Like, we literally said that when we walked outside, and he, like, totally 180'd on me. I was like, when I left there, I was like, he impressed me.
Yeah. Because we were, I think we were talking.
I don't know if I texted you guys. I'm like, oh boy.
I think we were talking about doing, like, a fake OnlyFans inquiry that was going to say, like, talking about relentless solution focus in the bedroom. And Brad was like, I don't think that's going to be his vibe, dude. Like,
I don't think he should. He was surprisingly cooler than you thought.
Just the stuff, like, so when we got there, maybe he was busy, but he was just like, yeah, so, like, it's not my job. Find where you want to do this. Like, it's a fucking mansion. Like, we come walking in, like, didn't know if you had a place that you wanted us to record. And he's like, no, literally anywhere. Just walk around the house. So, like, me and Rich, like, walked around and we're like, okay, I guess we'll do it at the kitchen table.
Where's the house?
And then, like, where is it?
Yeah.
It's in Baldwin area, yeah.
So, brand new. It wasn't shitty.
That OnlyFans question, even though it was real, did come from Lars in Denmark.
Lars in Denmark.
Right. Yeah. Have we moved up the ranks in Denmark since we last talked?
I did get an email about Switzerland. I think
we're on Switzerland?
Yeah, Switzerland and New Zealand. Making waves, baby.
Yep. Perfect.
Yeah, we're dominating that. So, okay, who is, and next question is, who's your white whale of a guest? And the goal is to get them on in the next 50 episodes. So it'll be about a year, right?
I think I missed that 50 episode thing.
So in the next 50 episodes, who's your guest? And then what I also wanted to do was throw out $100 a man, right? So we all name these white whale guests. No.
It has to be acceptable.
But you can decline it right now.
Here's
the thing. Like, for obviously it can't be somebody super easy. But the idea is anybody can get any one of these white whales on, right?
So whoever gets them on gets $100.
Whoever gets one of the white whales on gets $100 from each of the other people in the
group.
I'm
going to be rich.
So somebody's going to get a smooth $300.
Emily Frisella?
I already got her.
Twice.
Yeah.
So who's your white whales?
Donald motherfucking Trump.
There you go. Damn.
That'd be insane.
Right?
I'll give you $1,000. You get that.
Okay, thanks.
I'm gonna say The Rock.
Oh, yeah,
that's a good one.
The Rock would be awesome.
I never see him do shit like that. So I would say
it's this fucking white whale. What are you hating on him for?
You're right. I'm sorry.
Wow.
I'm sorry about
now, Bobby. Whenever he says,
"Did you see Donald Trump go to podcast?"
He did.
Like, what the fuck? Like, The Rock is more realistic, I feel like, than Trump.
We'll find
maybe you can get Donald Trump here.
I agree. I'm sorry. I fucked up.
What's your
You read
stance?
Better than me. Dave Portnoy or Elon Musk.
Ooh, I like both those.
Yeah.
Portnoy would be great.
So Yeah, I had Dave Portnoy. I also had Ed Mylett, but I also feel, even though like Ed's a motherfucking badass and he's a G, it's like we already kind of are like one degree of separation away from him. And a certain somebody told us that he would help us have him on.
He told us other things too.
And he told us other things, but you were our role model, Andy, and we looked up to you and you fucking lied to us.
He was our favorite podcast and our least favorite.
He hasn't made a post about lying to people, has he?
No.
Takes time.
That's good stuff. So so with that being said, now that we talked about like our favorites and what we've done, I want to talk about some stuff that what we've seen, right? So how do you feel like you've grown individually since we started the podcast?
I mean, I can talk all the way back to the book club. I mean, for me, I was just fucking, I was not taking in any sort of content like this at all. Was that a year, over a year ago? How long was it?
It was like December. Last
January we started it.
So like almost 2 years now? Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
A year
and
a half.
Oh, we're approaching
around 2 years.
So from literally from that point on, I've grown as an individual a lot, especially in the business side of things. Lately, health a little bit more. But the big turning point for me, honestly, and the part that I had the most fun with on this podcast was Colorado. Like sitting around at night, just brainstorming, having like that mastermind stuff. Like I fucking live for that stuff.
Same.
Like I love that.
That was amazing.
So for me, that was like, that was the biggest point of this from the beginning to now.
Which is super interesting to me because I feel like, and maybe it's just be like how our minds work. I feel like looking back on that, we did such a shitty job on it. Like, and I won't say shitty. There are so many ways that we can get better. Like this year, I feel like it's going to be exponentially better just because of like, I feel like how we went about it. It was just kind of chop shop. It got the job done.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of room for improvement and how we do goal setting and stuff like that.
I like that Colorado trip because I can tell you, I've had that same conversation about doing that with, you know, four other friends.
Yeah.
And it never, never happens. So like the if anything, how I've grown is I've just turned into a doer. You know, like I stopped talking about shit and just like if it's an idea and somebody wants to do it, I try to make it happen. You know, like I try to go after it or try to see how possible it is. Instead of just talking about it. I think I got that from everybody here. So that Colorado trip was exhibition A for sure.
Mm-hmm. So does that mean we're doing it again?
Exhibit A.
We're going to go somewhere again. We're going to do another trip at the end of the year.
Tulum.
Should we open it up?
Yeah. Another poll or whatever the fuck you call it on Instagram.
Would you come?
Leave it to the people.
Yeah.
Yep. What do you got?
I mean, for me, it's just like, honestly, our group text that a lot of the listeners don't get to see and whatnot, I think.
Thank God.
Yeah.
I've never seen so many dicks in my life.
Yeah, we'd be canceled. It's an ongoing dong show.
Cocky.
You have to send one in the morning or you can't talk.
Mm-hmm. I send him after a cold shower. But
just so he can be on our level.
Yeah,
that's right.
I bet you if I put in B on your Google history, Bukkake would be the first one that comes up.
Oh my God. No. Well, I'll show you later. But anyways, for me, it's, you know, those group texts, I think, every day. Because we get together one day a week for the pod, you know, and sometimes we miss, you know, one of us will miss or whatnot. And doing that, I think, has created this, like, sense of urgency to keep up with the playing field, right? Like we all have our wins. And when we talk about them on that text thread or we talk about the things that we're doing, I think that kind of keeps me going a lot of the times because it's easy to get burnt out. But then, you know, if, you know, somebody does something good, it's like, fuck, I want to do that, you know? So I think that keeps me going.
Yeah, for sure. For me, I mean, there's a lot of stuff that, Dan and Brad, you guys talk about that is honestly like over my head. And as far as like being and obviously Matt, you as well, but some of the conversations that you guys have back and forth on the text threads, I'm just like,
fuck, man, these guys are just like, Dan's like, what if I, like earlier you were just talking about how you could get a boat and you're like, oh, I'm going to get this house and then I'm going to do this and this is going to depreciate. And I'm like fucking over here, like Rain Manning, trying to Rain Man some stuff. Like, all right, what's Dan doing? How do I do this?
Dude, he's got a 60-year note on the boat.
So the,
it's 100 grand.
So the level up part for me, like, I mean, I've made significant growth in me, myself physically and mentally over this past year. And I've mentioned on multiple podcasts too, like I'm not where I want to be financially. I do want to have a separate side hustle. And the compound effect has been a book that's, I mean, we talked about on the podcast last week. I have $70 that goes into a savings now once a week. So I have $10 a day, $3,650 saved a year, which I never would have done before. I literally pulled up, I was going through old notes today to see if I had any like weird ideas that I jotted down in my notes before. And I came across this list of things that I promised that I would do in my last relationship because I was a drunk, right? That was a huge thing that I changed. And I saw of all the things that I promised that I was going to do for her on there, I realized that none of them were a promise to me. And now looking through that list, the stuff that I wanted to do on there, which was save money. Literally one of my promises to myself was I'm not going to drink while I'm driving. Like that, it was
a good one.
It's a great one. Like as far as like the personal side of things, like I said, the physical side and just mentally stronger than ever. But from a business standpoint, like I said, not where I want to be, but being around you guys, like I know that at some point, like I will break through that barrier. And I just want to say thank you guys for like holding me accountable. And honestly, like Brad, like a few weeks ago, whenever we had like it was bad.
Yeah.
Like it was bad. And I, in that moment, wanted to quit. And I thought about it for a couple days. And a recent, like, I mean, whenever the Colorado trip rolled around, and I'm getting a little serious here for a second, I got COVID right before that trip. And immediately as soon as I got COVID, I backed out. And I made a decision based on emotion rather than actually like something that, thinking through something. And that's one of the big things that I've actually had a few posts on recently is not acting on emotion and taking the time to process some stuff before it actually happens. And I thought about it and I talked about it and I talked about it with my girlfriend. I was like, I love doing this, but I was like, this happened and this was really shitty, but I do love doing this. And I've never had the amount of accountability in just that like conversation. And it wasn't so much accountability as like, fucking come on, Bob. Like, let's do some.
I mean, it was very upfront. I mean, I went on Bobby hard. Real hard.
And you know, like if I could go back in time and like switch that conversation to where it'd be more constructive, I that'd be great. Yeah. But you know what? Like it got through to me. And I actually talked about this with Matt the other night. I was like, even though that was like rough, like that was one of the best things that could have happened to me because I actually like I put out more content since then and I feel better than I ever have, even though I went through a lot of moments of self-doubt afterwards, where I feel that imposter syndrome quite a bit. And it's because, like, there's times where I haven't been held accountable. Yeah. So this group of guys here, the accountability is for real. Like, give it to us. Like, we give it to each other and whenever it needs to happen. And that's something that I really needed. So I do want to say thank you for that.
I want to say thank you for that one.
Yeah. Well, I am because, you know, like it's honestly, I've elevated in my opinion and I hope you guys see it as well, but I feel like I've elevated since then and sure, I want to continue. So.
And I was actually going to, and I wanted to tell you this is like, I'm super glad that you didn't quit, you know, because I think we have something good. And I mean, we're talking on a level where a lot of listeners don't realize this, but you fucking work with the same people every single day. There's going to be fights. There's going to be disagreements. There's going to be opposite views and there's going to be all this stuff. And so a lot of the people listening don't see some of the other stuff that happens, but I am glad that you didn't quit because that was a fucking crazy situation. But also things were said that were aired out. And I think that we can all get on the same page. And I think that just sets us up for success for the next 50 episodes, the next 100 episodes or however many we do. So I just want to say that.
Yeah. Yep. So I didn't realize how many different things like I've done because of the podcast. 75 hard would have never happened. I don't think
if it wasn't for us doing the podcast. Whether it's like a combination of actually interviewing Andy, but also just like seeing like you guys go through it. I don't think that would have happened. I don't think I've talked about this on the podcast or really to any of you, maybe Dan or Bobby. I have a professional coach now. And it was because Ben Newman came on the podcast.
I literally was going to text you about that yesterday to see how things were going with that.
It's good.
It is.
It is. Yeah. There's been ups and downs, but it's been on me. And it's been like me confronting like my own bullshit, right? And so like I literally at times like look at this guy as like almost a therapist in terms of like me just airing out everything that's in my head. And we're like lasering in on where I can make the biggest leaps and bounds. And so it's been like my finances, which again, by most standards are pretty good, but there's always room for improvement. So the finances and driving my revenue forward. And so those are going to be things that we're working on. And then I start phase one in September. So I'll have, my tasks are going to be geared towards that. So 30 straight days there. So professional coach through Ben Newman Companies. If you're ever looking for one, I highly suggest it. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, sweet.
It's not Ben.
No, yeah, it's one of his
Ben
coaches.
Charges
yeah.
about $5,000 a month from what I hear. It's a guy that I'm really clicking with. So since starting, I went from zero employees to what's like, I guess under me technically like three with like Jacob starting Dan. Since he's under both of us, leaps and bounds on our company. I truly believe that I'm a harder worker. I really believe that since starting the podcast, I am 100% a much harder worker. I'm starting to enjoy my work more. I'm starting to get into what people call deep work, where it's just like I enjoy, like we talked about, like I enjoy working late, right? I enjoy like doing shit when I normally wouldn't be doing stuff, which is huge. And then the real estate side hustle. I might have started that, but I really think the podcast helped push me just to develop a different avenue of revenue. So a lot of ways, a lot of smaller ways, but those are the biggest ways. But still a lot. That's a lot of fucking different things that have happened within a year and a half.
Yeah, I was thinking that like over the last 18 months, my life has fucking been great. I mean, no, it was never bad, but I think exponentially, you know, in a spot of gratitude, you know, like every day I'll be thinking like, holy fuck, like how did I even get to this revenue mark? And how do I, you know, like we have the podcast and I have this business and I have this going on. I have these employees who, you know, if they listen, great. But I genuinely think that they enjoy working with Matt and I. Like I genuinely think that. I'm not, you know, maybe they hate it, but I think we've created a fucking badass culture. To where like these, you know, I would die for these people, they would die for us, you know, type thing. And so that kind of shit is like where it's like, wow, like this is crazy, you know? And so I always worry like, am I a one hit wonder? You know, because it's weird waking up and just being like, well, fuck, like how did I get to this point? You know? And so the podcast and the content and the things that we do and the things that we talk about will keep pushing us all into the direction we want to be in, I think.
Well, I think it's good that you're not comfortable because once you get comfortable, you're not going to keep pushing yourself.
That's what I was just going to say. Yep. I think that mindset right there is what kind of keeps you pushing. The fact that you know that you could be a one-hit wonder.
And that he pumps a kid out like every fucking year.
I still tell myself every day I'm broke. Every single day.
And you tell yourself every day you can't fuck too. Because you're fucking pumping those things out.
I fuck for at least 20 minutes.
Yeah. But at my life calls
maybe there is natural talent.
There you go. Ed Milet calls it blissfully, what is it? Blissfully dissatisfied or unsatisfied, something like that, right? Like life is good, but there's always, it's always looking to get better.
So I think that like that comes with the thermometer thing, right? Like me telling myself these things isn't me telling myself negative things. It's me telling myself you can do more. You're not where you know. But I at the same time, I can be very grateful for what I have, but I know that there's more, you know, room left in the tank. So
yep. Colin, you got anything?
Let me shoot. Yeah. I've grown as a professional and as a man for sure. And I think one thing that that this podcast does or did for me and does for all of you guys is, I mean, if you think about it, so how long has this been going on? Like 19 months? How long has this?
Well, no, I mean, Well, yeah, I guess the
closing book, in on 2 years, from book club.
From book club.
So 50 episodes. That's that consistency is that's fucking incredible.
You know, probably only and missed like 2 or 3 weeks.
And yeah. I think like 6 months of that were just like.
And to be in constant conversation, like mm-hmm. I can't tell you how many times I thought like, oh shit, like I'm thinking about making an excuse, like, oh, what would Brad say about this? You know what I mean? Like, it's you constantly like think about that stuff, and that's why you guys have helped me, you know, get to another level in my business. And then in my life, like I feel like when I read the one thing, it brought a lot of structure to my life. And then seeing how you guys operate in your business, I see the importance of it. And not giving up on my physical goals, my money goals, and my business goals, I wouldn't be where I am right now, supporting a family and you know, looking at investing some, you know, my money in other places, and I wouldn't be looking at a lot of different things. So
I'm chewing gum in the microphone.
In the microphone, damn right.
Nice shot.
Did anyone remind him, or did he just have no gum?
I don't chew gum anymore, man.
He's been told this a couple of times.
I've just grown a lot. Just having you guys in my circle, I still find myself referencing conversations, and you know, you guys just make me bring it. So
yeah. Well, I think like if. I mean, obviously, everybody here has grown. And I mean, I think it's visible at every single person you look at in this room. It's not like we can just say, oh, yeah, I've grown. It's like I can look at Brad. He's grown. I can look at Matt. I can look at Bobby. I can look at you, Colin. We've all kind of evolved into another version of ourselves, you know, over the last 12, 18 months. And so it just shows the power of us having the right people in your circle and getting together and actually talking about shit like this on a regular basis, how important that can be. So
for sure. Yeah, it's super important. So then where do you guys see the podcast helping you the most down the road? You as an individual.
I think a big thing for me is just the continued accountability. I think it's something that as just someone who wants to be a leader, this is kind of it. You talk about the personal and professional development, then there's action behind it, whether you have physical, financial goals, be able to call your shot and see that actually play out, I think is something that is really important, because no one in my family is doing anything like this, like entrepreneurial, like anything like this. They're not necessarily trying to get better, like, physically or anything like that. And I think a lot of people are just kind of, they're comfortable. We talked about it last week. People are happy, comfortable because it's easy. Mm-hmm. I think the podcast is just going to force us to do more uncomfortable things, and we'll grow.
Absolutely.
For me, the biggest thing is like, I called it networking, but like, I'm never going to use this podcast to like sell anything or to sell myself or anything like that. But I look at it as like building a circle, like, pretty much next summer. I know it didn't happen this summer, but I'm probably going to be hanging out with Purcell in his pool smoking a Cuban. So that's what I think. Hey, I think it's just good to be rubbing elbows with these people who are at like the next level. Like, because like it should be said that none of us are comfortable where we're at financially, I don't think. Like,
right.
I mean, I feel like I am literally just scratching the surface of where I want to be. So like, I want to be like in that circle where I'm sitting there smoking a cigar with fucking Frisella.
Yeah, my income's doubled, and I still feel like—
Has it really?
Yeah, I still feel like—
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, from the buddy. Time we started, absolutely. And more than doubled. And I still feel like— I don't feel like anything's changed. You know what I mean? I still feel like I'm chasing other—
Dude, you
know,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
You know, this actually it all kind of started. You and I met, Dan, because you were giving me shit for selling insurance. Remember? What the He's fuck are you doing selling shit. Insurance? He's sending me screenshots on Google like, this is the average insurance salary.
Well, that's because he called me with a generic scripted sales pitch.
Oh my God.
And like, talk to me like a fucking person. And then you'll be successful.
Yeah.
But no, I mean, at the end of the day, like for me, to Brad's point really is, you know, I don't know if I'll be fucking hanging out with any of these dudes, but I know that I'll hopefully get a chance to just see their lifestyle for a day and see what's possible. You know, I always allude to me going to Florida or wherever and seeing other people on yachts. So you know, I see it, and these motherfuckers can do it. I can do it. So it's the same mindset when you see Frisella or like another, if they can do it, you can do it. Yeah. I can do it. Anybody has the capability of doing it. They all say the same shit. They all say there's really no secret sauce to it. You know, you have to have the right principles. And I think you have the right skill set that you build up over time. But there's no...
A year ago, we weren't texting yachts to each other.
That's right.
That's true. So not only can you see that we've grown in our business, in our finances, spiritually, mentally, emotionally, whatever, but it's like our mindset. Like the, and that's what I was saying. Like, so ever since I started this podcast, my level of certainty that I'm going to become a millionaire has exponentially grown steadily. Like just about every time that we talk and every time that we do a podcast, and obviously I still have times of doubts, but it's like, and I'm not talking like I'm going to put money aside and like one day it's compound effect's going to hit. Because if you have $1 million by the time you retire, you don't have fucking shit. But like, I'm talking like, I don't know 100% for a fact that I'm going to be $1 million earner and it's going to become sooner rather than later. Like I am, it's crazy how much my mindset has shifted. And it's not to say that I'm close to there yet, but it's like, I see it, right? I see it unfolding. I see the layers peeling back. I see how it's possible. And it's the podcast is a living embodiment of how to get better in any area of your life. And that goes back to my quote, right? It's the people you surround yourself with and it's the content that you consume. So if you're always talking to people about, and then law of attraction, right, Dan? It's like, if you're always talking to people about how you're going to be a millionaire, about how you're going to be a, you know, own a yacht, about how you're going to have a jet, like what's cooler? What should I get first? What's cooler, you know, the yacht or the plane? Like, it's like, you keep talking about that shit. You start to put pressure on yourself to like, how do I become that person? And that's exactly what this podcast has done for me. And that's what it's going to continue to do, I see, going forward. And
it's also about
really
who you
cool
say
people.
It to, though, too.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
if you have a bunch of friends who aren't doing shit, and you're like, I'm going to be a millionaire, and they're not doing shit, you're not going to hold yourself accountable, because as long as you're better than them, you're good. But if you have, if you talk about being a millionaire, and then you got Dan sending you a $6 million boat, you know, he's trying to depreciate that, you know. That helps you out a lot.
Well, I think it's the whole, like, and I don't actually know if this is true or not, but I've been told this, and it's a decent metaphor, where if you take a shark and you put it in a small tank, it'll only grow a certain amount.
Yeah.
And then you
Goldfish
take that shark
is the term I heard.
And you put that in the fucking ocean, it can, you know, get as big as it fucking wants. So,
what are we talking about?
I'm just saying, like, in terms of, you know, the circle you're with, and in the you're saying the people you're around, they limit you, because as soon as you're the top of those people, that's it. Like, you know what I mean? So, you know, my goal is to be the bottom, is to be, you know.
You always want to be chasing somebody.
Never be the biggest fish in the small pond.
Put me in a bigger fucking tank,
you
know, with, and that's where I'm going with it. Hopefully that fucking makes sense.
It does.
It does.
Yeah,
sure.
I hope you guys are in the pool with me next year with Priscilla.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe Frisella will be in my pool.
Maybe.
Yeah.
There you go.
Look at that thinking.
There we go.
There you go.
Always one-upping.
Yeah, always.
Always. So this is good stuff. This has been a fucking awesome podcast. So here's the last thing that I have before we get into the OnlyFans inquiry, and it's probably what everybody else wants to know, but where do we see the podcast helping others down the road? Like, this is obviously just a business to us now. It's, you know, it went from a hobby and selfish reasons to something that we feel like is actually helping others. Along with ourselves. So where do you guys see the podcast helping others down the road?
I can voice it, like, my vision for this pod is really to create content. Is really not a podcast. It's a brand around, you know, I know the professional name is fucking douchey, but we've kind of owned it to this point and we kind of laugh about it. But if you actually dive into it, it seems like everybody that we've talked to has been pretty happy with our content. And so to keep creating more content and building out that brand. And my vision for this whole thing is, you know, I'll just throw out a goal, a long-term goal is to have like a conference at one point, you know, with their listeners, with people who want to be a part of the brand. And it's not for me. It's really so that there's so many fucking people out there that want more and they just can't find people, you know, immediately who want that shit too, you know? And so to bring people together in that space is my goal.
That was the exact same thing I had wrote down, was having events where, like I referenced earlier, like in Colorado, like that was such a small deal. But if we could do that on a large scale and like see these people, like Colin saying that he's doubled his income, like to have people come a year later to the conference the next year and be like, hey, dude,
give a testimonial.
This is what happened.
Yeah.
And be like, well, fuck,
Yeah.
I feel like I was a little part of that.
Fucking legit. 100%.
Like changing people's lives to me is like something that's really cool.
Yeah. Get to a point where you have something like, what was it called? Summerfest. Is that what they do at First Form?
SummerSlam
or something like that.
Summer Smash.
There we go. Teamwork. So
Smash Slam.
Yeah. Being able to have something big like that. And I mean, think about it too, is that we have a lot of different people listening to the podcast that might want to get better in different areas. There might be someone who's like, dude, I really want to be mentally stronger. I want to be more physically fit. I want to have my real estate business booming. I'd love to start my own company. The list goes on, and it goes back to Dan, what you were saying as far as having a big conference. And if we can segment it into, all right, this person over here takes over this wing. It's like the Barstool Sports effect, where they have their main Barstool Sports page, but then they have one that's like Barstool Outdoors. Then you have Foreplay with Riggs. Then
just
you
the
have
tip with Matt.
Just the tip with Matt.
That would be an awesome segment.
Like, Matt, just you could do consulting. You could be like Hitch.
You have all
he
these
has
different
that look.
He could do it.
Hitch look. Will Smith.
So you were trying to take a home. You were trying to take a chick home with all lesbian friends. Let me tell you a story.
Oh man!
I went home with the gay guy.
I mean, why don't
sometimes
we make that?
You gotta do it.
I told you not to say that on fucking live air.
Why don't we make that a goal? Why don't we try to, when we do our Colorado trip, which may not be in Colorado this year, it might be in Colorado.
Our retreat, wherever it is.
I think we should try to. If there's anybody listening that is still listening to this episode, but if they are listening, you know, if they want to come, like, hit us up. We want to meet some of you guys. Plus, you know, if we know anybody in our circle, honestly, invite them and see what we can make.
That's my favorite thing about you. Well, why don't we make it a goal? That is
we got to fly private this year.
I think that's how this podcast helps. Like, hey, why not do it?
Let's go.
Why is it impossible?
Yeah. I mean, you guys basically touched on everything I was going to say. It's been cool. Like I said, it's been 50 episodes, and this is actually probably one of the funnest podcasts I've done. I also, Rich, I want to say, I kind of just want to keep this our spot from now on if it's just us guys.
I like this room.
I like this setup. Yeah. I think it's dope.
You get to touch the mic a little more.
I can touch the mic.
Yeah.
Could you imagine
him in sex? Like, well, let me adjust that.
Oh my God.
Oh, shit.
So do we want, what are we at? Do we have an OnlyFans inquiry or do we have anything else that we want to talk about before we hop into that? You know what? Fuck it. This was actually a pretty long episode and we're running out on time. Actually, we're 15 minutes over. This was good. This is plenty. You guys don't need an OnlyFans inquiry because we do have a lot of OnlyFans inquiries.
We'll get to
it
next
week. But
we're
going to wait because we realized we went so over on this podcast. So
I feel like we'd be cutting them short on an answer. I don't want to do that.
Exactly. So a lot of good content here, guys. We appreciate you listening. Thanks for coming all the way to 50. And here's to 50 more.
Let's go.
Cheers. Deuces. Thanks.